Welcome back. This is the Clay Golem. We're in Foundry VTT and we're starting something different. So, Curse of Strahd, my absolute favourite module from D&D ever. We're going to be building it. We already had a look at a couple of things in a previous video about how we can do that more kind of assisted theatre of the mind, using that phrase, because obviously we are supporting that with images and things. Yes, version 12 Foundry, probably 3 months away from where we are at the moment. Yes, it's going to change the way some things work, especially with the active tile triggers from Monk. But I don't want to wait. I'm going to crack on. I've got players who are coming up to the end of their Fandelva campaign and will be looking to do something new. And one of the groups in particular, I want to put them through Curse of Strahd. Right, so let's create a brand new world. Let's do this. So if you've not seen the early videos, you're completely new to Foundry and you don't know what's going on, let's quickly whiz through. Add-on modules. I've got a whole bunch of them, but I'm starting a brand new game world, so none of them will be installed. We're only going to install the ones we want, and this one is going to be much more that theatre of the mind style than the previous, when we've done Stormwreck Isle and Fandelva, very battle map heavy. This is going to be a bit different. So we're going to be using completely different mods. Game system, Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition. I've just double checked and updated everything to make sure my game engine is updated, all my modules are updated. So let's crack on. New game world. Curse of Strahd is what I'm going to call this, and I'm going to be using just for this campaign adventure series, nothing else. So we're going to leave it in the Curse of Strahd. Game system, of course, we need to select that. Background image, yeah, let's select a background image. Let's do that. Let's stick it in here. Happy to stick it in here. Let's choose a file. Don't want to be in that folder, do I? That's completely the wrong place. Let's go to our, perhaps not even characters. Let's go into Curse of Strahd, into our scenes. What would we like to use? I've actually done a bit of organizing of some folders here. Let's use Strahd himself. Why not? Okay, we don't need to worry about join page. Fine, everything else, that's all good. Let's just create. And here we go, we've got our game world. So straight away, launch that. Off we go, lovely jubbly, log in as the game master, and we're in, da 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 da, but we've got nothing. Okay, so first of all, I'm gonna clear that chat, because thank you very much for bringing that to me, but I don't need it. Very first thing we're gonna do, first scene, what we're gonna do in this video is we're going to create a landing page. It's not something we've used before. We've talked a little bit about it, but we've not done it. And I want to do it for this one, because again, Curse of Strahd is special. So let's create a new scene, and we're going to call it Landing Page. I might change the name of that later when I think of something a bit nicer. Here we are, and I want to go find my background image. So I'm going to go into my folder here, going to go into Maps, into my Curse of Strahd, and choose my new folder. And I have created a landing page already. Dun, dun, dun. Here it is. Oh, all the way over there. Right. So this is a image that I generated using the Midjourney. Bit of a study. And this is going to form the basis of this particular scene for this landing page. There's a number of different things we can do here. Step one. Let's get rid of that grid. Don't want a grid on a landing page. That's nice. That's clearer. So we're going to be able to use a whole bunch of these different things to make them interactive. So I've got my picture of Strahd up there, which is, I think that's worked quite nicely. So what I did was open the image and I edited it to put Strahd into that frame. It's not brilliant. You know, my artistic skills are not great, but I have managed to put Strahd into that photo frame. And I've also stuck the map on here as well, ready for an active tile. Now, you can't really tell a lot from that map just by looking at it. Even if we zoom in, it's a bit blurry and everything, which is exactly how we want it, because we don't necessarily want the players having access to it. But we've got all these lovely picture frames. So we can put images in there, like the player characters along the bottom, for example, and things like that. We've also got some nice books here that we can potentially put little titles on for them to click as they learn information and they learn about different places. We can give them access to journal entries or documents and things by clicking on each of the books. So I thought this would work really quite nicely. All right, so let's start off by putting a first portrait of a player character in. Let's pick this left one here. So to do this, we want to add a tile, but we want to be able to click on it. And in Foundry 11, that's not a thing. It is or will be in Foundry 12, apparently. So we need our first module, which is going to be Monk's active tile trigger. Which will be under M, won't it, for Monk? Splendid. So let's install that. Easy peasy. Go to our configure settings and you can see, yep, nothing installed. You just saw me create the game. Default trigger is enter. Not worried about that. Default controlled. Again, I can change all of these specifically here. I don't think there's any defaults I need to worry about for Monks. That's all good. All right, so I want to create a new tile here. Excuse me, a little bit of croaky voice. Let's go to tile browser. Go into here, go into my character portraits, and I'm going to pick a very large, huge Haley. All right. Blimey, Haley, that's a bit excessive, mate. Let's bring you down. And we want to fit you into this little portrait here. Okay. So we can stick Haley in there. And let's just make sure we're happy. There we go. There's Haley's portrait in that picture frame. Well, it's quite nice, doesn't it? I really like the way that this works. So let's select that because we want to make this a trigger. So let's just check we're happy with everything else. We don't want to play with the opacity, although we could. I mean, one thing you can do is if characters die, is you can drop their opacity here, but still keep them in as a memorial, which is quite a nice idea. Right, happy with size and everything else. Do I want it overhead? No, don't need to worry about that. It's not animated, but I do want it as a trigger. So, not on enter. Restrict, allow all tokens, not worried about that. Anyone can click. Doesn't need to be double click, just click. Allow when paused, yes. Hover pointer, token must have sight, not worried about that at all. But what happens when they do? Anybody does click on it. So we want the action. And we want to pick the fact it will open the character sheet. So I haven't used this one before. I'm pretty sure it's in here. It's going to be embarrassing if it's not. Close dialogue, create token, delay actions. I'm just reading out a list now. How exciting. Open journal, open actor sheet. Yes. And I haven't got my actors in, have I? I haven't bought Haley into this. Right. So, let's close that. Because if I haven't got my characters in, getting overexcited. Okay, so back to our modules. And we want the DDB importer, this one here, because this is my... Don't have to do it this way, of course. I can just create that actor. This is my preferred way of bringing stuff in. So in my other window, I'm just quickly popping to D&D Beyond, find my character. So excuse me while I do this. View Haley, got her shortcut, her web address for her character. So with DDB importer, I can create actor, give it any name. It's a player character. And on here, I've got my D&D Beyond. Now, if you're kind of going, blimey, what are you doing? You're moving too fast. We have done a video. Go and look in the video series about add-ons. There is one in there that is the DDB importer that shows you what the heck I'm doing here, because I'm kind of rushing because, you know, you guys have seen, most of you, some of you have seen this before. So if you haven't, then great. There's a video. Go watch it. If I'm smart And remember, I'll put a link in the description to the Monk's Active Tile Trigger add-on and to the DDB importer. So while I'm gossiping and talking about that, we have a Hayley. Brilliant. She's in. Everything lovely, jubbly. So I've now got that. Let's go back to our tile. So back to our tile trigger. Here she is, very small over here. Tile trigger, anyone click, and it was on actions. We wanted add, and it was, what was it called? It wasn't create token, open actor sheet. So it's an open, and we want to open Hayley. Hayley Longbreeze. And happy to show it to everybody. No secrets in my party, although obviously I can choose to restrict. Show to. No, hang on a minute. Show to the triggering player. Okay, I do want to do that. If I have it everyone, what happens is one player clicks on Hayley and everybody gets Hayley's character sheet open for them. It's not a problem that they can see her sheet, but then somebody else is clicking on their character and we've got sheets opening all over the place. So anybody can click to open Hayley's character sheet and have a look. But it only shows it to the person who's clicking on it. Right, update tile. Should we check that works? There we go. Click. Opens it up straight away. Really, really easy. So this is how we're doing our landing page. All right, so let's do another one then. So I'm going to... I know. I'm wondering. I want to create a new tile. Why's it going that direction? Come here. I want to create a new tile that is going to be for our map here. Okay, so that's going to be our tile. Now, I can absolutely add the picture on for the map. Not that it makes a lot of difference, and you'll see what I mean in a moment. Curse of Strahd. Let's put the images on. There's my map. So we can pop the map in there. And, of course, that map is all squiffy and everything else. But I can rotate it 90 degrees. No, I didn't want to rotate. It's all right. Oh, it's... Yeah. Stupid boy. Okay, let's not rotate it. Doesn't matter because this is only the tile trigger. So for this, I'm actually going to make this one invisible. Okay, so we can't see the map image. Which is fine. I just want it as the active trigger. So again, go to triggers, active, yes, not enter. I want this to be when they click on it. Anybody can click on it, even when we're paused. They don't need to have sight. And when we do, what I want it to do is, and again, this is not one I've used before, but it should be quite straightforward. It's a very effective little module. Is I want it to open URL. No, I want it to not play noises, not preload an image. I want it to show image. I've said show image. Actually, look under S might be useful. shush. and there's my map. Okay. Caption. Map of Bavaria. Have I spelt that right? Oh no, hang on a second. Just checking in the other window, make sure I haven't. Because you lot won't. Barovia. Barovia, not Bavaria. Barovia. I was thinking that doesn't sound quite right, does it? Barovia. That's it. And again, don't want it to open for everybody, just for the triggering player. Update that. Lovely jubbly, and that's the specific image it's going to open. We should be able to update tile, and again, we can click this, it opens Hayley, thank you very much, and click here, opens the map. Now that map's a bit bigger than I was expecting, but that's fine. I mean, look how pretty that map is. It's so beautiful. But it means that the players can in fact do that and look at that map, which is beautiful. That's great. Now what I will do is, not right now, is I'll have to log in as a player and check all these links and things work properly. And especially, it's fine for this character sheet, that's fine, but for this image, look how much bigger it is than the playing area. So this might come up absolutely ridiculous because it's just showing the image in its normal size. So I may need to just have a little look at that and make sure that that is going to work. If possible, if necessary, I can just resize the image, not a big deal. All right, so this is it. This is how it's going to work. Now I'm going to show you an example of what I mean about these books, although I'm not ready to do the books yet. Let's create a tile. So we're going to create basically a trigger tile here. Let's just do this. Let's give it... So I haven't created an image for this, which is a bit silly for me to say. I'm going to do this, and then I haven't actually prepared it. What I could do... Let's just use anything. Yeah. Let's just use anything for now. But what I will want to do is I'm going to have my tile like this. What I would like to do is have it show text, but I haven't actually organized it. So this is what happens when I don't prepare. You guys are so used to that. We don't need to be overhead tile. We don't need it to be an animation. We do want it to be a trigger. Now we've got the size and everything else. So what I need to do is to create a image that is this size, so 120 by 32 pixels. So that's useful. I know what size it needs to be with the words that I want on this journal entry. So from the adventure, there's a whole bunch of written stuff. So I might have an entry about the lore around Strahd himself. And as they go and discover that Strahd is a thing, I can show this tile. And then off they go. They can go and read stuff. And as they learn more and more and more, I can reveal more and more pages as part of that journal entry for them. So for this one, triggers, again, it's going to be a click. Anyone can do it. Activated, allow it when paused. Don't need to worry about having sight. And the actions for this is going to be, I need to create a new journal. Let's stick with Strahd. We just create that, add a page about him. Not really use this as a journal, by the way. This is nonsense. And what I will probably do is, again, rather than just writing on here and using the text editor, blah, 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 and picking a nice font and things, what I probably will do is find an image with like some parchment type looking image and write it on there in a nice font, a suitable font. And instead of having this, it will be the page I add won't be a text one. It will be a image. And that way they can come in and look at the different images as if they're flicking through scrolls and stuff, which is kind of a nice way to do it. So back to my active tile trigger. Let me get rid of that. Back to my active tile trigger. When we add, what we want to do here is when they click on this, we want to not create journal note. We want to open journal. We can select the entity. Please select a journal. We're going to target Strahd. Thank you very much. Which page are we going to land at about him? We haven't got any subsections. Show to, again, the triggering player. I'm not sure what as image is. How interesting. Should we find out? Yeah, let's do it without first. Okay, brilliant. So clicking on this book here, it opens the journal exactly how I expected. But let's change that triggering thing to as an image, because this might give us a better result. Okay, at the moment it looks the same. but as we put some details and things in there, that might change. So that's what I'm going to do with these books. And they're going to be on a range of topics. And I may well have one of them, which is the player's journal, that they can click on, they can add to, and everything else. So this is it. This is my landing page. This is what I'm going to use. One other thing, sort of interesting thing about Strahd is there's a number of different ways they can play. So you do a equivalent of a tarot card reading at the beginning to work out where certain things are. The idea is there's a bit of a, in inverted commas, random chance of where the powerful items are going to be. It means the game's a bit more replayable, which is nice. But what happens when they collect those things? Now, I've fiddled with my image, but I've not put it on here yet. So I'm going to create a new tile. I'm going to go to my tile browser. I'm in my Curse of Strahd here. Let me choose a file. And I have the holy symbol of Ravenkind. That's one of the things they can get. Now, I'm going to drag that out. It's flipping enormous. But I'm going to shrink that down. And now I can choose a place to hang this. Now I want to make it, or maybe I can have it leaning up against there or something like that. Maybe actually if I'm going to have it leaning up there, I want to get rid of that silly chain. Okay, but what I want, and they might not notice it at first. This is the point. They may not notice it. So this is going to be a hidden icon, and I'm going to do that with the other things as well that they can find. There's going to be a number of things that they can find. They're going to be on here as they. So this is going. This tile here for the map. It will not be activated until they know where they are. Then they can open the map and have a look at it. They're going to be able to look at their portraits, of course. They are not going to know that these hidden tiles are in the scene already, but as they discover that item, it gets added to their scene so they can come back in and have a look. Now, are they going to have a party loot box? I think so. I think we want them to have a party loot box, and I'm thinking this box down here at the bottom, and again I'm going to make that clickable and they can open that and use it as a vault. Hang on a minute, how do we do vault? We need an item pile, don't we? So let's quickly do that. Let's go back to our manage modules, and we need the item piles. There we go, item piles. We need both of the added bits on there. We can do that. Reload, da 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 da. And now we can create an actor that we can call. Party stash or whatever. We can rename it later. We can leave that as a non-player character. Party stash, that's not a problem. And if we don't do that, if we go to configure, this is where we can say enable this. Okay, so we're going to enable this as an item pile. Go to other settings, and we want this to be a vault. How big do we want it? 10x5, that's probably enough. If they run out of room, they run out of room. Enable expansion items, no. Base expansion, no. Restrict vault access. By default, everyone can access vaults. Yes, I think so. Manage access, I don't need to particularly restrict it. It's for the players. They can chuck what they want in there or not. Clear vault logs, that's fine. Nothing on the main settings I need to change. Yes, stack items. Yep, that's all good, and I don't need to fiddle with that. Okay, so this is what it will look like when they open this. Lovely. So, if we open Party Stash by clicking over here, whoops, I've done it twice. By clicking on Party Stash, it comes straight to here. This is what we want to do. So, how do we make that work? Let's create a new tile. We're going to put it there. Going to adjust it a bit. Let's zoom in so it's easy for you guys to see. Just going to make that nice and big like that. And I'm going to, again, I'm going to just make it invisible. That's the word. Just make it invisible, make it transparent. I'm going to go back to my triggers. Anyone who clicks on it, it is activated. It will happen when paused. Don't have to have sight. The action, again, just like with Haley, we want to, was it open? Was it open character sheet? Open actor sheet. There we go. Shush. and we're going to select party stash, and it's going to open it for the triggering player. So update that as well. So here's our scene. Oh, hang on a second. Oh, it's because I'm DM, so you will always be able to see the tile, which is fine. But as a character logged in, I should be able to, when I have access to it, click on the map, be able to see that, click on any of the characters, be able to see them. It could be that we include some NPCs on here as well. This amulet, what's it called, will become available as well once they've actually found it. They can click on the books once they've put the titles on to get out their journals, and they can click on the chest down here, which immediately opens their vault that they can stash money in here. They can put items in there, whatever they want to do. So just to prove that point, if we open up Haley, so badly phrased, I can take her tinderbox and she can leave that behind. Okay, don't need that. She's left it behind. It's now in the vault. So somebody else can take it if they want to. They might have extra weapons, extra bits of equipment, and you can use this as a bit of their home base. They might, you know, just gather treasure there to sell on later. It's a nice handy place for them to keep it. All right, a couple of other bits I want to do before we end this video. If I right click on this landing page, I got overexcited. I didn't do much in the way of configuring. So let's make sure that it's going to start in the middle for us. I don't need to worry about background or anything. Show in navigation for all players. I want the landing page to be accessible by all of the characters, or all of the players rather, or all of the time. If they want to come here, they can. We already looked at grid. Lighting, no token vision, no fog. I do want global illumination so they can all see it. And ambience wise, we don't want weather effects, you know. But autumn leaves in house doesn't make a lot of sense, does it? So we don't want those either. Now, what I do want to do is actually find some music we're allowed to use to put on here. And if I can't find any that I can actually use that you guys can sort of hear, even as a demo, I'll add it, but obviously not be able to demonstrate that in a video, you know, copyright strikes and everything else. Okay. This is a much different approach, isn't it, from what we did with Stormwreck Isle and things, which is very traditional tabletop battle map oriented, as I said right at the beginning. I think this brings us a whole new feel. This is just our landing page. It's not perfect. I've got to do these book icons, putting on other characters and things. Now, obviously, when my players join, I'll have to go through and update all of those images. It's not a big deal because the triggers, the tiles are all in there, but I will need to update the links. But I want them to fall in love with this and feel that they can come and access it. Now, some of these images, they are going to stay as normal images, but with an invisible tile. So maybe as they encounter particular NPCs and stuff, you then make that tile visible. So this picture in the middle, for example, looks like that. And then suddenly at some point it changes and it's a different picture. That's kind of what I'm thinking and how I want to do that with the tiles. And the whole time, even though they are, you know, they're seeing these other photos and things like that, the whole time they're in the landing page, this figure at the top is watching over them. But they don't know who that is. They've not even heard of Strahd for a fair bit of the intro to the adventure. But all the time they're at the landing page, he's kind of watching them. I like that idea. All right, so I'm going to bring an end to this video. Got a bit more work to do on the landing page, of course. Let me know what you think. Do you like this idea? Do you use a landing page? Some people do. There's quite a few people out there saying they always use a landing page. Other people go, no, I don't bother. It's not something I normally do. But like I say, Curse of Strahd is special and it deserves our respect. And that sounds a really weird thing to say, but it's, you know, we should treat it with reverence because it's just legendary. So this is where I'm going to go forward with this, and for my campaign, just so that you know, we're going to, there's four possible ways that we can start. I've already selected which way I want my characters to start. That's going to be our first scene. I want it to start being, or appear to be, a bit light and cheerful and stuff, and then descending into dark and misery. So that transition from their normal world into Ravenloft is really quite stark for them. That's my plan. I want to create atmosphere for it. Shall I shut up now? Thank you for watching. Please leave a like. Like I say, in the description, let me know if you're using or not. I'll try and put links to these modules, add-ons we're using, so that if you haven't, you don't know what we're talking about, you can go watch those. And if you're watching this and you're not subscribed, please do so. It really, really does help. If you click the bell icon, it means you'll be notified when I do the next video in this series and the other add-on ones. If you don't want to be spammed by that, please subscribe anyway. Just don't click the bell icon. It really helps out the channel, whichever way you do it. All interactions are good interactions. Thank you. You take care. Bye-bye.